contest is scheduled for Woodfall. Taking their weight of the line from Cameron, North Carolina. At a combined weight of 430 pounds, Matt and Jeff, the Hardy Boys.
The Hardy Boys set for tag team action here on SmackDown. And King, tonight's SmackDown is brought to you by Milk. Go down Milk and get this collectible super-sized Milk mustache poster of The Rock. Go to WWF.com for details.
And by PhoneFree.com. Free long-distance calls over the Internet.
And by WWF Meat Snack. 60% less fat than the leading brand. Who said we don't have great taste? Get it at 7-Eleven stores near you.
And our opponents, introducing first from Lima, Ohio, weighing in at 249 pounds, Al Snow.
Okay, it's been said before, King, but Al Snow and Steve Blackman are truly the real odd couple of the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, I mean, you know, I don't know why they're so odd. It's the fact that this guy's a lunatic, carries a head around with him, and all of a sudden he teams up with a guy that has, well, less
and
personality than
a team partner. Stoneville, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 246 pounds, the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman.
Well, he may not have personality, but since he's been teaming with Al Snow, Steve Blackman and Snow have been on a winning streak. They've let him get to lose.
Yeah, but I miss the good old days of head cheese. There's head.
Steve Blackman and Al Snow set to take on the Hardy Boys, and which is an important matchup for both of these teams.
People, head cheese. They're chanting.
Well, Blackman doesn't like it. So it'll be Al Snow to start things off against Jeff Hardy. Of course, the Hardy Boys without their manager, Terry, at ringside.
Hey, just thought of something.
What?
How popular do you think head cheese is going to be when we get to Milwaukee in a few weeks?
Oh, come on.
He's got to wear the big cheese in there.
Al Snow with right hands to Jeff Hardy. Terry, of course, at home recuperating after being powerbombed through a table a few weeks ago by Bubba Ray Dudley, and you have to believe, King, that Terry's watching the broadcast tonight. What do you think she was thinking?
As a matter of fact, my sources say that... Oh, wow! He went right over the top of him. My sources say that Terry is unable to watch these matches. It causes flashbacks.
Well, she wasn't.
Too much trauma.
If she was watching, could you imagine what she'd be feeling when she watched Bubba Ray Dudley powerbombing BB through a table here tonight?
Right, that's what I say. She'd be totally traumatized.
And here's Matt Hardy, cover hook of the leg, and a kick out after one by Al Snow. Again, Terry recuperating at home, psychological trauma, and she may never, ever be back here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, I personally volunteer to go down and help her heal. And, you know, I'm a good listener.
BB's been sent to a local medical facility after damage done by Bubba Ray here on SmackDown earlier tonight. Matt Hardy whipping Al Snow into the corner. And here comes Jeff. The Hardy Boys consummate double
teamers. Oh, man.
And there's an example of that on Al Snow. And here comes the Lethal Weapon into the ring.
And these Hardy Boys, I mean, you know, they'll sacrifice everything to it. They could care less about their own personal safety. They'll do absolutely anything to win a match. Whoa, man.
The Hardys involved in the first ever tag team table match at the Royal Rumble last month against the Dudleys.
Oh, look at this!
Oh, what a double team by Al Snow and Steve Blackman. I'll tell you, Snow and Blackman have been working well as a team, Jen. You have to give them credit.
Talking about teams, some people have been saying that the Hardys are the team of the millennium. I don't even know if they're going to make it out of here today.
Al Snow choking Matt Hardy, center of the ring. You know, speaking of teams, Triple H and X-Pac going to team up later tonight against the Big Red Machine, Kane, in a handicap match.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be some match. It's kind of aptly named if you think about it.
Kane mentally handicapped. Well, can you imagine Kane? He cannot wait to get his hands on X-Pac.
Oh,
face first Matt Hardy into those steel steps.
Come on, when you do something like that, Blackman, show some emotion. Smile. Enjoy it.
Al Snow taking advantage. Cover on Matt Hardy. Hooks the leg. 2. Jeff Hardy breaks up the 3 count. The Hardy Boys have had their problems with the Dudley Boys. We mentioned what happened with Terry a few weeks ago, their manager. But having even more problems here tonight with Steve Blackman and Al Snow.
What would you think would, I mean, if he doesn't like head cheese, you got any other ideas? I had one that everybody could relate to.
What?
The Blackman. And, of course, head. They could go as Blackman. Oh,
everybody gets a
Blackman.
Kick out after 2.
House knows otherwise. Here was Snow Bunnies. Remember that one?
Yeah, I wasn't crazy about that one. Head tease is still my favorite.
Steve Blackman shoulder block to Matt Hardy in control. Crowd again chanting head cheese.
I'm telling you, it's a natural. Go with it.
Steve Blackman doesn't like it. Al Snow does. Blackman second row. Now he rolls out of the way. Blackman allowing that chant to distract him. Can Matt get to Jeff Hardy?
Steve Blackman should never leave his feet.
Blackman, a martial arts expert. So quick. Nice side rush and leg sweep by Matt Hardy on the counter. Can Matt get to Jeff to make a tag? Needs to make one. Matt rolling over there. Makes the tag to his brother Jeff, and here comes Jeff Hardy. Drop kick to Steve Blackman. Al Snow in as well. Takes the legs out from under him. It's Jeff Hardy. And Jeff, oh man! Kick to the midsection. Al Snow up over the top rope. Oh no, King. Jeff's gonna fall.
No!
Coming over the top rope, wiping out Al Snow.
That's a suicide dive.
Twist of fate. The twist of fate by Matt Hardy on the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman.
Could be in for Blackman. Look at that. Look who's here.
Dudley's come away with a chair. Double back to Jeff Hardy. Come on now. The referee distracted by Devon. Didn't see Bubba Ray.
I did not hear it.
And can Blackman and Al Snow take advantage?
I know there's still out crowds making a lot of noise, but there's a ref deaf and blind.
And look at Bubba Ray, still in that trance.
Oh, man!
Still off the top rope.
That did it.
Steve Blackman, the cover hook to the leg, and it's over.
I'll say it for you. Give the assist to those damn Dudleys.
Tag team division. They remain undefeated. Yeah, thanks to the Dudleys, Al Snow and Steve Blackman pick up the win. King Dumfries.